Hey, you guys, I'm a filthy mess from working in the garden, but I have some really crazy new things that I've got to just share with you. And one of them is that see if you can see that. My May pot passion flower is in bloom. Yay! Isn't that just gorgeous? And the whole vine is just loaded with them. I just love that. Yes. That is really cool. That's new in the garden. And look what I just noticed. So that's also new. Where'd that show up? That's the, if you didn't know, the passion vines can become invasive and they do pop up somewhere else. So I'm gonna have to pull that. Y'all, look what else is new in my garden. In the food forest, I'm getting star fruit blooms. Oh my goodness. So this is a bell carambola. This is my, it was a baby star fruit tree, but look, it's actually got blooms heading on this way. Now I did see these before and I was like, oh cool, it's putting on new leaves. Like kind of in a weird place, not growing at the end of, you know, well it is growing at the end, but you know, it was kind of interesting how it was coming between. And then I look and I see this and I'm like, oh, that is fantastic. Look what else is going on. I've got two baby Cavendishes. And this is the full-size Cavendish tree. So I have a dwarf, and then I have dwarf on the other side of the yard. And then I have two babies there. And I have two babies here. I'm so excited. And I just can't hide it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's a tomato. That shouldn't be there. Probably Everglades. You know what this is? Fuchsia forget-me-nots that got left in the seedling tray. And I totally forgot to plant them. So I just plant four of them right here. And I put three out in the front garden. This is also new in the garden. Now, it's not open right now. But these are my salmon pink 4 o'clocks that I put in. Yeah, so I might have to come back out here with the camera later and show you. I got a whole nice little patch of them. Ooh, there's a wasp up here. Y'all, I've lost track on what number we're on, but I was in here. I was actually looking for my old passion fruit, little piece of fruit. I knew it wasn't working. It just didn't grow right. So I was looking in here and look what else is new in the garden. Oh my gosh. Okay, this one is so much bigger and better than the other one that I knew that wasn't growing. So that makes me have hope that this is actually, it's probably been up here for a while. This is the Lady Margaret, and this is going to be her fruit. And oh my gosh, I cannot believe I'm getting a passion fruit. A real one. Oh my goodness. There better be more on this tree. Oh, I hope, and I've just not seen them. So this is Allamanda, and it's in partial shade, and I do nothing to it. It's just a fantastic bush. Oh, I lied. It's not the last thing. I have one more thing. Ooh, but anyhow, it's all of a sudden come out with these little spiky things. Look at that. That's its seed pod, I would guess, right? This one's not quite dry. This one's really green. This one just showed up. Oh my goodness. So this is like weird. But we're going to follow the progress on that. And that's pretty neat. So I guess it got pollinated. Look, there's a little one there. That one's much smaller. I don't know. That's all I see. You guys, so I can't actually show you the last thing by video, because I can't capture on video, but I finally caught it with a picture last night, a couple of pictures. So up front where I have red salvia, and then I have the purple showers or the golden dewdrops, the Duranta erecta is the actual scientific name, but I have it up front. And I was sharing in that hummingbird video that we happened to see the hummingbird there. Well, when I did the transplanting of all the new plants and I was watering last night, I did the transplanting today, which is why I'm a filthy mess. But last night I was watering everything, preparing for the transplant last night. And there was two hummingbirds fighting right over there. And I was like, oh my gosh, I got to capture this for you guys. So it's proof the hummingbirds are right there on the plants. My little evil plan of making a butterfly garden in a pollinator-friendly place is actually coming to fruition. I am so happy. Y'all, you don't know. I mean, this was like a desert for pollinators here when we moved in. I mean, there was woods and everything, but there was nothing for them really to eat. We had had probably, I think there was like seven citrus trees. There was at least five like navels, something else, and then I remember grapefruit, a ruby red grapefruit. We had all that here and it all died with citrus greening. And you know, it was awful over here. And then here it was just, you know, I did gardening a little bit, but I really didn't incorporate a lot of flowers and plants. So really it has been my mission this past 12 plus months, really since COVID, I think, you know, is when that hit. I was like, all right, that's it. I love vegetables and everything, but I have got to do something to bring in pollinators so I'm not hand pollinating. So I hope you enjoyed these pictures. I'm going to put them over my voice as I'm talking, and I know they're not the best quality, but it was just before dark and I was totally unexpecting it. But y'all, they're here. We have all sorts of pollinators, including some of my favorite, and they're on the plants, not just on the feeders. So incredibly happy to be making the environment for pollinators, especially hummingbirds. I would love just to make this their happy place, you know, like when we close our eyes and we go to the Bahamas or we go to the mountains or something like that. When hummingbirds close their eyes, they're like, yes, let's go to Miss Robin's yard. Let's go to Southern Latitudes. So anyhow, you guys, I hope you enjoyed seeing all the new little changes that just have happened in the yard. I think I'm just about caught up on all the videos, so now we're back on fresh stuff. Okay, take care, you guys. God bless, and I will see you again soon. Bye. Hey, you guys, I have to come back with addendum. So you saw me show you this passion fruit, and I think I showed you the second passion fruit, at least I did on Instagram. But I just came out here to sort of trim up some of this, and I just realized, oh, so that's two, three, four, five, six, seven. Uh-oh, I hope that wasn't one. But six and seven. Hold on. Eight, nine. Look, we're gonna get 10. Oh, I'm sure there's all sorts of fruit up there. Look at all the flowers. All right, so we're gonna go with at least 10 passion fruits, the Lady Margaret variety. Also, another addendum to my addendum, because you know, I pass by this tree every day and I just haven't been looking at it. Ooh, there looks like that might be some aphid pressure. Ooh, yeah, yuck. But I was noticing the new growth, which usually with new growth comes aphids, but also look at the ants are running like crazy. The ants were probably coming in. So look, new growth everywhere across this whole tree. Jack and I did a little pruning, I don't know, a week or two ago, maybe as much as 3 weeks ago. And I said, that may stimulate it. And sure enough, it stimulated it. And look, I didn't even pay attention and notice that this week or last week, maybe it put out blooms. That's probably the week I did the VBS art camp. And oh my goodness, not only did it put off blooms, but that one for sure looks pollinated. I don't know about the others, but it looks like I'm going to get some fruit there. And I think we counted about eight limes on this tree from early spring, but I sure would love to have me a second crop. Yes. They will usually put out another couple, you know, a couple flushes through the spring and summer, especially once the rain starts coming. and we have had some rain here lately. So anyhow, I just wanted to show you that. That is another new thing that's been going on in the yard, and I'm so excited about it.